Welcome to this video where I'll be demoing the IDO from IN API Wizard. This wizard will be able to create IDOs off of an IN API endpoint. Make sure your Mongoose version is 2021.05 and above to use the features of the wizard I'll be demoing. Before we get started with the wizard, make sure you have the IN API file uploaded to Mongoose in the IN API servers form. If you are unfamiliar with this process, I have provided a video link on how to do this in the resources at the end. Next, you want to add your suites to the server IDs. In here, I have a suite associated with each server ID, but you can also just have one server ID with multiple suites in it. Next, you want to add the methods for that suite that you want to call. The wizard will grab from this list. As an example, if I wanted to get my Mingo user detail, I would go into the Mingo Swagger doc and use this method endpoint here. Note that the method path is after the suite, so in Mingo's case, it would be this, or just what's shown in the Swagger path. But for M3, the path to the URL would include these from the base URL. After the server ID suite and methods are set up, we can begin using the IN API wizard. Go into the runtime builder, select ext data source, and IDO from IN API wizard. Select your server ID and suite. You have the option to use SSO, which means the API call will be made with the current user. Otherwise, it will be using the service user that was used to set up the IN API file. The proxy path is taken from going into IN API, API metadata, under App Suites, Suite Contacts, and Operations. Enter the suite that you'll be using and the rest path of the method that you are calling. For this example, I will use user data. There can be more than one proxy path, so make sure you use the right one. The API I will be using is the M3 version 2 one, so this is the proxy path I want. Now I can select one of the methods that were set up in the IN API service form earlier. So I'll be using the list user data API to generate an IDO off of this. Make sure that the Swagger file path generated has a similar format to this. Otherwise, you might have a wrong proxy path or the method is in the wrong format. Hit next. And you should see the input parameters for this API should match the ones in the Swagger. I can provide some values like the US ID or customer number like in the Swagger doc, but since this is not required for this API call, I'll hit next. This next page is the list of all the output parameters, and you can select the ones that you want to be returned to Mongoose. Only the ones that you select will be created for the IDO. Next, you have the option to add a post method. Before, I was using list user data to get a list of users. Now I can set add users as my post method for adding users. Make sure you are familiar with the API endpoints. Otherwise, go back to the Swagger to check which of the inputs are required. These input values will be the IDO's property generated from the output parameters. Make sure there's no typo and that it matches the IDO property you're using. Double check that you include all the necessary properties in your output. Put method is for updates, but since there's no API for updating the user, we can simply skip this one. The delete method we can set to delete user. And it looks like it requires the user ID as the input parameter. Finally, give it an IDO name. An IDO project. And hit finish to generate our IDO. Open up the unload IDO metadata cache. And clear the IDO cache. And after signing back in, should be able to see our newly created IDO. To see our IDO in action, let's create a new form off of it. Now, if I open up my form and hit refresh, it has grabbed the list of users from the list user data API that I chose before. In addition, I can add and delete users because I attached a method to the post and delete method. So for example, the list of users is currently 70. If I wanted to delete record number 3 and save it, the next time I call the list user data, it should only return 69 records. This shows me that the record has been deleted from N3 since it is not returning the record anymore. Next, I can try adding a new user. Unfortunately, I do not see my new user. To find out what error occurred, I can add a new property to my IDO for debugging. Set the new property to be unbound like the rest. Give it the property name of infobar with a data type of string. This info bar will contain the debugging messages that you will use for debugging your API calls. Now let's add an edit box so we can display the debug messages. The info bar requires an extra step to tell the IDO to output to it. So you need to go into the IDO, go into advanced options to the load save overrides, go into insert, hit new, type will be name method, we will use post IN API data. And for the parameters, I want the property name to be info bar as the output. That's done, hit OK and save. Now if I try inserting a new user, I can see in my info bar that it says the record test 10 already exists, meaning I can't have a duplicate US ID. So now with more information, I can add another record with an ID that I know does not exist. And the insert should go through. And I can see that in the response. Here's my record. In addition to performing insert and delete on the form, you may want to trigger it in an event in the background. You can do this via form script using the update collection request, like any other IDO, just to be sure to supply all the required parameters that the API requires. I have added three buttons to the form and attached an event to each of them that calls their respective methods. Clicking load will call my load collection request, but instead of loading from a local kit table, it will use the list user data API. The insert method will use the add user API that I attached in the post method during the wizard. After closing and refreshing my form, I can see this is the record that I inserted. Now if I wanted to use delete, it should also delete this record with the user ID of temp1. So refreshing it, I should see that record be gone. And it has been deleted. I can also apply a filter to this IDO like I would any other one. What's happening is it's recalling list user data, but with the filter that I applied. If I wanted to apply a filter on a property that's currently not in my IDO, like say max records, I can go into the IDO and manually add it. You can do this for any of the fields that is currently not in the IDO. Make sure that the naming is exactly as is shown in the API. Now if I apply a filter of 5 to the max records property and hit filter, it is going to call the list user data API with the new filter that I've added and return a list of users with their max record of 5. In summary, this is what you should have learned throughout the video. And finally, here are a few links to resources. The first is a video walkthrough of how to import the IN API file to the IN API servers. The second is a doc with a step-by-step walkthrough of what we've done through the video.